Hey friends, welcome to Chime Coaching. Rob here with my good buddy Nilesh. In this video, we're going to talk about the pros and cons and compare living, studying, and working in different parts of America. Welcome again. Got my friend Nilesh here, who had the great experience of actually living and working in the Midwest, East Coast, and West Coast. Yep. During his studies here, he's going to talk all about that. At Chime Coaching, we really want to see international students succeed here in America. Be sure to subscribe to stay connected to future great content that's going to help you out. And Nilesh, tell us about your adventures.
So I'll just introduce again. I'm Nilesh. I'm a CS master student. I graduated a few days back. In my master's, I actually did three different internships at three different cities. Mm-hmm. So first internship was in Dallas, where my university is situated in. Mm-hmm. That's the Midwest. After that, I got a chance to work in Boston, which is Northeast. And I went there in fall, so pleasant weather. Mm-hmm. Away from the heat of Dallas.
And you saw the beautiful fall colors in Northeast.
Oh, yeah. And then I saw like heavy snowfalls in December. Mm-hmm. Then third internship I did was on West Coast in Palo Alto, California, which is a part of San Francisco Bay Area. Mm-hmm. Silicon Valley, a dream place for every software developer to work in. Mm-hmm. So I got a chance to explore three different big places in US and see more culture from there.
Yeah. Yeah. And so you just recently graduated. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And what are you doing tomorrow morning?
Okay. So tomorrow morning I have all the bags packed and I'll be flying to Silicon Valley and getting started with my new job.
Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you.
Nilesh is going to be starting his full-time job tomorrow with SAP in the Bay Area. Mm-hmm. So really proud of him. And he's got a lot of great insights. So tell us, what's it just like to live and to travel and to experience different parts of America, and why internships are a great way to do that?
Honestly speaking, I did more experimenting with my internships. People generally do one internship and they get done with their graduation. But I'm a bit of an experimental person, so I did experimenting. So my first internship was in Dallas in summer. And it was in the same city where my university is. Mm-hmm. So I realized that I didn't get much chance to travel US. And obviously you can't travel from Dallas to some far away state by road, so you have to take a flight and it's costly.
America is so big
and it's so costly, so you are on a tight budget and you're like, okay, I'll do this later on. So surprisingly, I got my fall internship in Boston and I was thinking like, should I go for it or not? Mm-hmm. And then I decided, okay, I'll go, because that was a high time for me to go out of Dallas. It has been like three semesters I was there and I didn't get a chance to see a different culture, a different world. And I heard so much about Northeast, Boston, and Eastern Coast, which is like a historic thing.
Near to New York City.
Yeah, I mean, exactly. Like, if you stay in Dallas, you don't have like very big cities or tourist landmarks near Dallas. Mm-hmm. But I was like, okay, let's go. Let's take a chance and explore the things along with, you know, working with a new company. I went to Boston. First thing was, I was working with a product-based company, which is very famous. So that was a big deal for me.
Yeah.
Especially coming from India, knowing about that company, using their tools in my student life, and then working with the MathWorks on their platform was a really good experience. Mm. So that was in terms of, you know, academics and everything. Mm-hmm. In terms of exploring cities, Northeast is a very beautiful place. Mm. And I went there in this start of fall, when Dallas was heating with like 105 Fahrenheit. So I was like, okay, that's nice. And then you see a complete different culture. So I had a very limited perception of US culture and US people. And when I went to Northeast side, I saw a very different culture. Like, people are so much patriotic. They have that Northeastern accent, which you don't find in Dallas.
They gotta drink their coffee.
They drink their coffee with their donuts and bagels, maybe. And then Dunkin' Donuts is a big deal there. Like, you find a Dunkin' Donuts like a chai stalls in India, same way. I got a chance to explore a lot of states nearby Boston.
All over the East Coast.
All over the East Coast. So we traveled a lot because we were earning quite a good money. And then we had a good holidays. And we were basically there in November, December time, a good holiday season. So got a chance to visit a lot of places like New Hampshire, best for fall colors, Vermont, then Washington DC, Philadelphia, New York, New Jersey, and the big deal for Indians, which is Niagara Falls. So drove across the states, covered a lot of states.
And they're so close together up there in the Northeast, right?
One of the important things, yeah, I was gonna say that, like, you know, they're so close, like you travel 50 or 100 miles and you're in a different state. So that's how we ended up counting so many states on our visited list. That was a good experience, looking at a different culture, meeting different people, struggling with the changing weather, because December they start their winter start, and then
harsh winters,
so you don't see those harsh winters in Dallas. So big snowstorms, airport getting closed up, you are locked down in your apartment on a weekend in a heated room. So all that experience was nice, and it changed the perspective about US culture and people, their food, how do they celebrate. So that was a nice experience. Another experience was going back to the California, because by the time I went to California, I almost explored most of the Northeast coast. So when I went to California, that's a whole new culture. As far as you are a CS,
very different.
very different. Especially if you are a computer science guy, you are a developer or related to a software industry. That's like a dream place to be.
Why is that?
First thing, a lot of companies are founded and started from a small garages in California. So take it like Facebook, Apple, and you name it, all the big names. So, and another thing, best weather in US, like the best. I have seen like a heavy summers in Dallas. I have seen worst winters in Boston. And I would say, like, if you are, you don't want to rush through the heavy winter, or you don't want to face the heavy heat, California, and especially the San Francisco Bay Area, is the best place to be. In California, I was working in a Stanford research park. Along with my company, I had VMware in front of me. I had Skype office right beside the SAP. I had a Tesla office right behind my company. And I had like all big names around me. I got a chance to visit Google campus. I got a chance to visit San Francisco City and the Bay Area, the famous Golden Gate Bridge, took a photo with there. So again, that's a very different culture when you compare it to the East Coast, because people are more techie. Like, I won't you know, tell you the lies, but I met an Uber driver who used to be a CEO of big multi-billion company, and he used to run a successful company in his around like 90s and 2000. So you can meet anybody anywhere in a coffee shop and talk tech. That's everything is about tech. Like, you can find somebody who is a startup founder somewhere in a grocery store. So that was a pretty nice experience to explore.
So how many total states now have you gotten to visit?
I guess the count is 15. Yeah, I almost visited the 15 states, and a lot of states out of these 15 I visited when I was in Boston.
Okay.
So one of the major count comes from my Boston internship.
Awesome. And then you've taken advantage of other work and holiday opportunities to travel, which is, we highly recommend to come and experience the culture. So when students ask a lot of questions of, where should I, what's a good location in the US for studying or for living or for working? And America is so big, the cultures and the cities, East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, you know, they're all so different. What would you say to that when they ask that question?
So when I have to answer this question, there are a lot of aspects for this particular question. Lot of things and lot of parameters come into the picture. When you want to stay and learn in US, first thing is your living expenses. Along with that, the job opportunities. So, and it's always a trade-off. Like, if you stay in a small city or a small town where there is no much technology and business, your living expenses will be very less. But then your opportunities will be obviously with less. But when you say you stay in California, in Bay Area, your living expenses are like four times compared to Dallas. But then your opportunities are very high. That's why a lot of people prefer San Jose State University, because it's like, if I have to give the example, it's like staying in Bangalore downtown and studying there and then working there. These are a few things. Along with that, it's again weather. If you don't want to, you know, face very harsh weather, you have medical conditions, you don't want to go there. How the area is safe to stay there. Do you have Indian people around you? Do you have Indian grocery stores? Because a couple of states, I know my friends were interning and they didn't have an Indian grocery store in a 100-mile radius. That's tough for an Indian guy. You can't survive on burger and pizza every day. These are a couple of things. But along with that, it's the company, mm-hmm. what all things you're learning, mm-hmm. what your opportunities there mm-hmm. to explore for your full-time jobs. Yeah. These all parameters come into your picture.
And what about the transportation? How would you compare the transportation, either problems or opportunities in uh-huh. the different places you've been in the US?
Okay, so first I was in Dallas. Dallas has a decent transportation, I would say. Mm-hmm. And especially if you stay nearby university, you have all the free buses and everything, so you don't have to pay a dime mm-hmm. for your transportation. When I went to Boston, I was like 30 miles out of the Boston downtown, mm-hmm. a small town. So transportation was horrible there. Like you don't get much public transport. You at least need your car, or you have to carpool with someone.
To go into the main city.
To go to the main city. And mm-hmm. then if you have to take a public transport, like a commuter train or something, it's pretty costly. Like it used to cost me $18 for the return ride. That's too much for a student. Northeastern, like Boston, even the Boston city has a good transportation. Outskirts of the Boston city, they don't have a good transportation. Mm. When I went to California, California has all different culture about transportation mm-hmm. because they have a lot of traffic problems.
Yeah.
A small, congested city.
Yeah, they have the worst traffic.
They have the worst traffic, yeah. So if you go by road, it takes like 45 minutes to cover 15 miles in heavy traffic mm-hmm. in a peak hours. But then they have a pretty nice thing called carpooling. Mm-hmm. So you won't believe, I used to get a ride to my work location, which was like 15 or 20 miles from my home, in a dollar.
Yeah, for a taxi.
For a taxi.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So how much would that be in Dallas?
That will be around $30 to $40.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because California has a good culture of carpooling mm-hmm. and a lot of companies give you discounted carpooling. That's mm-hmm. how I used to get $1 ride. Mm. So, and they again have their commuter trains if you want to travel across the city. A lot of small cities or the dense cities have a Uber Express and Uber Pools, mm-hmm. which you won't find in Dallas or Texas. So you can save money on that. A lot of people use bicycles mm-hmm. if it's nearby, or they use a bicycle to go till the public transport stop, take a bus or train and go mm-hmm. to your workplace.
Yeah.
So this is how the picture of transportation changes.
Nilesh, do you have a favorite city or state out of all the places you've been to in America so far?
So a lot of people must be expecting it should be somewhere in San Francisco Bay Area or Silicon Valley. But if I get a chance to live and work, best city I would say is Chicago.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm okay.
Why Chicago?
So I visited Chicago recently. That was my last stop on Northeast Coast. Mm-hmm. So Chicago has one of the best architectures in the world. Hmm. Like, you can just get lost into that architecture. You just go on the river walk and you can sit there with your coffee or a book or a movie for a whole day. Mm-hmm. So, and it's one of the best architectured city in the world. Hmm. So you don't find much traffic, people are honking, small roads. That's not a part of Chicago, even if you go into a downtown. Mm-hmm. And you know, normally when you go to a downtown, you face a lot of struggle with the traffic, mm-hmm. people, crowd. Chicago is best. They have one of the best food culture as well.
Yeah, it's a foodie city.
It's a foodie city. So go and try different pizzas mm-hmm. and go and try different things. And you'll find a lot of tourists there, like a lot of tourists. So if given a chance, I'd love to go and work in that city.
Hmm. Yeah, you had so much fun visiting your friends there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I even like Chicago a lot. Uh-huh. Those deep dish pizzas are so good.
So good. So good. High with a calorie, but so good.
Yeah, it's worth it.
Yeah, it's worth it.
Use your cheat day for that.
Oh, yeah.
So Nilesh, any final tips that you want to give to students when they think about either cities or regions of the country mm-hmm. for studies, for living, for working? You know, what do you want to leave them with?
Yeah, so good question again. I'll suggest, like, if you are getting an internship opportunity, use it in terms of your academics and job, but mm-hmm. always use it as a US exploration opportunity. Mm-hmm. If you are going somewhere which is a big city, like say Boston, mm-hmm. or you're going into California, mm-hmm. you can always visit the states and the tourist places nearby that city. And mm-hmm. you know, road travel is so cheap, just mm-hmm. to rent a car and go there.
Yeah.
So along with your academics, your jobs and your future mm-hmm. perspectives, always use internships as a traveling opportunities. Mm-hmm. If you are on a tight budget and you don't want to spend much on traveling and across the US, in my opinion, it's again a personal perspective, but mm-hmm. always Northeast part, like Boston and nearby cities, maybe DC has a good industry, and again a West Coast. And Dallas is like a safe haven, low cost and decent amount of opportunities. Mm-hmm. But again, you can try different things and speak with different people and check all the parameters like weather, money, opportunities, and everything, and you can decide.
Yeah, at Chai and Coaching, we're all about fostering community, building bridges cross-culturally. I loved how Nilesh has traveled and explored all over our country, explored the different cultures and different pockets of America, which I definitely have enjoyed doing in India and other countries all over the world. And so, yeah, please come take advantage of that. Yeah, have fun while you're here.
Yeah.
Come to study, work hard, but have some fun too.
Yep.
Which Nilesh and others have definitely done, and you won't regret it. Because once you start working full-time, it's going to be hard to do that.
Oh, yeah. You don't get us, like, you know, you have to always plan your things when you're full-time. When you're a student, you can easily leave in between the weeks. And
for the holiday.
For the holiday or travel, because you don't have classes every day. But once you are working, you have to always take a Friday night flight and come back on Monday morning. And that's the costliest flights you find.
So yeah, take advantage of it while you're a student to travel and have fun and explore the culture and the sights and the beauty of America.
Yep.
And so thanks for joining us. Be sure to subscribe to stay connected with us or even connect on other online platforms like Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, or our WordPress blog. And we'd love to stay connected. And we'll see you guys next time at Chai and Coaching. Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.